As millions of American families are getting ready for the big Super Bowl weekend, one family has a happy dilemma, the Harbaughs. John and Jim are the brothers coaching the opposing teams. Today, they made a little bit of history, and ABC's Josh Elliott is in New Orleans. Josh.
That's right, Diane. Here in New Orleans, it is the ultimate case of sibling rivalry. Two brothers separated by a mere 15 months, leading their respective teams now into the biggest of games, which means tussling over 100 yards of turf and really family bragging rights.
Team!
They shared the world stage today, the first time ever that rival Super Bowl coaches held a joint press conference before the game, and definitely a first for brothers, who seem to have much more in common than not.
I concur.
They are just over a year apart in age. John, 50, Jim, 49. They shared a room in their Toledo home, and they sure know how to share a laugh.
Philosophical commonalities? I'd be hard-pressed to spell philosophical right now.
No, we couldn't spell commonality at this point.
Their differences are subtle. John, by all accounts, the more outgoing and jovial. Jim was his usual reserved self. But when it comes to coaching, they were forged in the same red-hot cauldron of competition. Their father, a longtime coach, and their mother, who refused to lose.
Well, there's nobody in the family that has more competitive fire than my mother. She competes like a maniac.
No one would fight more for us than our mom, you know, no matter what the situation was, or teach us really how to have each other's back.
The strategies they'll use this weekend, they learned long ago from Dad, who says he knows where his heart will be after the game.
There's going to be one winner, and there's going to be one that's going to be totally disappointed, and my thoughts go to that one that will not experience the thrill of victory.
And no matter the intensity of their rivalry, both personal and professional, really, no matter what happens on Sunday, they do both agree on one thing, Diane. One day, they'd both be happy to coach with the other.